In your book, Mr. Puigdemont, that you no longer see a role for yourself in the future.
Well,
what do you mean?
It's quite difficult for me to talk about the future. And
why is that?
Because I don't know with what will going on next week.
So you've written the book, The Catalan Crisis, an opportunity for Europe.
Well, I tried to write a letter to the European people.
Aren't the Spanish people the first that you have to convince?
Well,
what do you mean by an opportunity for Europe?
Europe can have an opportunity to be more stronger.
And I'm sorry, Mr. Puigdemont, but they're not interested in your case.
Are you sure?
Well, they haven't reacted. Can we say today in Catalonia, compared to last year, nothing has changed?
Well, yes, we are start our path to independence. We are more independent today than one year before. We are a political subject, de facto. We are recognized as a political subject, de facto. Of course, we are not.
Madrid doesn't think so.
We are 7 people in exile and 9 people in jail. So our decision was to my decision, the decision of my colleagues who are in exile, is to continue to fighting.
Do you still have impact from here on Madrid and what is happening there and the new prime minister? I can imagine it's a bit harder from here to do so.
Well,
And the fact that you left, because your colleagues are still in jail, do you feel that you've abandoned them, maybe?
No. People in jail can't see their son. And it is very serious.
Do you see your family now and then? Do they come over?
We spent last month of August here in Waterloo together.
In terms of organizing the referendum and claiming legitimacy, you haven't gone the whole way. And on the one hand you say, okay, there has to be a democratic solution. Well, if I were your adversary, which I'm not, I would have said, well, then you should have at least done that in a proper democratic way.
With all the sympathy I have for the fact what you're trying to do, I think it's a big mistake in the way you treated it. It was very amateuristic. If you want to earn some dignity, I think you should go back and lock yourself up in jail with your friends. If I was the leader of such a movement, I would want to be with my friends. And I cannot understand why you are here in the studio and not with your friends in Catalonia.
Yes, because if I was in jail, I couldn't be in that studio. I don't believe in the martyrs.
If you didn't want to have martyrdom, you shouldn't have organized a fake referendum but a real one. And then probably the outcome would have served at something. And now it was done in an amateuristic way, and then you lost a lot of credibility. And I think that's a bit the problem. Once you lose credibility for a case, you can't expect that the whole population is right behind you. So that's an issue.
The referendum was not a fake.
You should have organized a proper democratic referendum.
Yeah,